The Great White North fights back against COVID-19. Canadian universities are front and center, tackling this crisis and tracing its impact on our lives. This is Universities Fight COVID-19 from Radio Western. Each episode, we'll tell you about COVID-19-related research and commentary coming out of Canadian universities. Today's episode is from University of Alberta, Augustana Campus. The next time you encounter someone with a conspiracy theory on COVID-19, don't dismiss it. Instead, try to understand why they think the way they do. First, people hate uncertainty. Certainty means safety and security in a dangerous and unpredictable world. People will often encounter dangers that are harmful or fatal. And even if we take care of ourselves, we will all eventually die. For many, this is a difficult reality to accept. We will pretend that these dangers don't exist, or we'll minimize them. And so, pretending that COVID-19 is not that dangerous is no different. Our intense dislike for uncertainty means, for example, that we'll refuse to believe that COVID-19 is simply a random result of a virus crossing from bats to humans, and instead, we'll probably believe that the pandemic is part of a larger plan. After all, if someone planned this pandemic, then someone is in control, even if the reason is sinister. Second, information transfer depends on trust. Unless you're gathering data yourself, you're not really conducting original research in the academic sense. And if you accept ideas of others or rely on others for evidence, you are trusting someone else. And sometimes experts can be wrong. So what happens to trust? Trust has a bit to do with personal experience. Since everyone's personal experience is different, who and what people trust is different. People also tend to search for and remember information that supports their prior beliefs, and they often overestimate their own intelligence. Mix all three, and you'll observe that not everyone trusts the expert on COVID-19. It's not that these people are uneducated or are unable to think critically. It means that they simply don't trust the experts. Third, the matter of plausibility. As of May 23rd, there is no cure or vaccine for COVID-19. Information delivered by experts is an educated guess based on the best available data. It gets updated or modified as we collect more data. So how plausible is that information? It depends on the information provided, but also how we perceive it. And perception depends on our education, our critical thinking skills, our personal and life experiences. And so, fear and uncertainty, a lack of trust in emerging information experts, and the plausibility of that information, combine all of this and you'll get people who believe in conspiracy theories. Once we recognize these factors, we can deal with the misinformation and its spread. Don't ridicule and lecture people. That does not work. What works is trying to understand how people think. This story was adapted from Daniel Sims' article, Understanding the Appeal of Conspiracy Theories, published in University of Alberta, Augustana Campus News. Sims is a history and Indigenous studies professor at that university.